Literally Me is something that everybody loves saying to movies like American Psycho, Fight Club, or anything that Ryan Gosling stars in. But what if I told you that the perfect Sigma male, the perfect Literally Me character, is not from a modern critique of society and masculinity? What if I told you it was from a 2007 animated documentary about penguins who surf? Surf's Up is exactly that, an animated movie about penguins who surf. It has themes of competition, sportsmanship, and what it truly means to be a winner. Shouldn't the quote-unquote perfect Sigma male embrace these themes, as well as the traditional themes of self-sufficiency, success, and integrity? To really understand the themes and what this movie actually stands for, we need to know the context of the movie itself.
Take one.
We start in the town of Shiverpool, Antarctica, with honestly a very good visual gag. Ignoring the fact that that's not how seasons work in the Southern Hemisphere, we're introduced to the main character, Cody Maverick, who is played by Shia LaBeouf. But in this movie, the only thing that Shia LaBeouf cannibalizes is those waves, dude, am I right? As we're introduced to Cody Maverick, we realize something about this movie. It really likes Green Day for some reason. I can't play it, of course, but Holiday, the opening instrumental to that, that's playing right now. As part of this first interview, Cody tells us the story of surfing and introduces us to the dude. Of course, by the dude, I mean Big Z. Big Z is the world's best surfer. He's Cody's, like, idol or whatever. You're not actually the best surfer, but he's more like the guy who made surfing cool. Think about the Beatles if they were surfing and also were good. Big Z visited Shiverpool when Cody was a kid and gave him a necklace. Then he told him basically to never give up. I know that sounds like the based epic Sigma Chad move, but for reasons we will later discuss, Big Z is not quite the Sigma he appears to be right now. Also, I guess this is a good time to mention spoilers for a movie that came out in 2007. Cody has a family, but they don't really believe in him. Like, his mom is supportive, but overall indifferent. His brother is pretty much the only accurate depiction of siblings in media I think I have ever seen.
I'm not touching you. Not gonna touch
you. Do
you
see this? Don't.
The whole town of Shiverpool pretty much just thinks Cody is a creep and a weirdo. What the hell is he doing here? He doesn't belong here. He doesn't belong. Cody recognizes this, gets mad, and so he drops a Midwest emo intro and then goes off to surf.
Cody's me, bro. Let me be me. When is that gonna start?
Lucky for Cody, a man exists somewhere on the other side of the globe. That man is James Woods. James Woods plays a smug otter who likes taking credit for other people's success. Again, sounds based, but isn't. Kind of a theme here. James Woods, whose real name is Reggie Belafonte, sponsors a surfing tournament every year, and in his own words, I'm scouring the globe for the next big thing. Hard cut to somebody else scouring the globe. This is Mikey. He's a talent scout who has scouted talent from all over the world, including Penguin and Penguin Japan. Also, he scouted the one surfer who's not a penguin for some reason. It's Chicken Joe, by the way. We love Chicken Joe. Mikey finds Cody and gives him a chance, but since Shiverpool is just kind of lame in general, Mikey starts to leave without him. Cody, in perfect Green Day fashion, risks his life for a chance to leave his hometown. And if not for Chicken Joe finally helping him up onto the whale, Cody might have been stuck there forever, and then we'd have no movie, which is sad. Chicken Joe immediately convinces us he's the best character in the movie in about two lines.
My name's Cody Maverick, Shiverpool. You?
No, I'm not from Shiverpool.
It still doesn't explain why he's the one surfer who isn't a penguin, but hey, I'm still on his side. Mikey hits us with a Marvel one-liner, and then we go straight to Pengu Island with a music montage set to, you guessed it, more Green Day. Welcome to This music montage introduces us to Pengu Island, the culture there, and again gives Chicken Joe the best line of dialogue in any given scene.
Oh crap.
She's big on you, Joe.
Called you crap.
Joe.
Here we meet Zooey Deschanel's character, Lonnie. Why is Zooey Deschanel here? She's a lifeguard, she's the love interest, and honestly, that's about it. Like any good Sigma male movie, the female characters are a little bit lacking. Cody tells us some more about surfing and Big Z, specifically that Big Z dies, and then he throws a rock at Diedrich Bader's character.
Huh?
Why is Diedrich Bader here? Anyway, Diedrich Bader plays Tank the Shredder Evans, who despite being the 9-time reigning champion of the surf-off, nobody calls him by his nickname, The Shredder. Everybody calls him Tank, including himself. Also, Tank is pretty much the fakest, like, Sigma male of all time. Imagine Patrick Bateman if instead of killing his co-workers, he just bullied small children. Cody gets mad that Tank is making fun of his dead idol, and so he starts to pick a fight. Chicken Joe has no enemies, so he tries to break up the fight but gets pushed aside. Then James Woods actually breaks up the fight and tells them to settle it on the water. Fast forward through 2 minutes of build-up, Cody gets his shit absolutely wrecked. He wipes out so hard that the documentary crew has to go interview the thing he crashed into. Two things about this. One,
stepped on me. Stepped on me? Are you kidding? This guy was dancing on me.
Two, it makes no sense that the sea urchin is sentient, but none of the fish from Shiverpool are, but I digress. Lonnie tries to do her job or whatever, and decides she needs to take Cody to the sick and twisted jungles of Pengu Island. Why the jungles? How many sea urchins have you seen in the jungle? They can't get you there. Here we meet a new character, Geek, and Geek decides that he needs to help Cody's sea urchin sting by standing up near a cliff, waiting for a Goomba to stand next to him, and, well, you know the rest. Since Cody went missing, Chicken Joe takes it upon himself to go into the jungle to find him. In a series of cuts, we see time and time again that Chicken Joe, you smoke too tough, your swag is too different, your bitch is too bad, they'll kill you, Chicken Joe!
How's it going, man?
Snap back to reality as Cody wakes up from the sea urchin sting and the subsequent concussion he gets from having a pineapple thrown at his head.
Oh!
That's not actually that important to the plot, I just think it's funny. Geek tries to take Cody back to the main Pengu Island, and in doing so, they find the Clash Royale log. Geek offers to make Cody a surfboard out of the Clash Royale log, and Cody goes, nah. Geek kinda gets upset by this, decides they're gonna make a board anyway, and they start to take the log over to somewhere to make the board. Suddenly, Cody and Geek are on the secret beach of all time, and upon finding a very small surf shack, Cody realizes something. That's Jeff Bridges! He was the dude in The Big Lebowski! That's who it was! That's who I was thinking of! Also, Geek is Big Z or something. Who really cares about that, though? Cody tries to get Geek to teach him how to surf, and Geek says no. I almost just hit, Geek says no, kill yourself. I don't think I'm gonna put that in the video. Cody tries to tell Geek to teach him how to surf, and Geek says no. Man, this is worse than that time I was a complete loser with no actual friends.
Tank, are you polishing your trophies again?
Mom, I wasn't polishing, I was talking to my friends.
After the Tank Evans cutaway gag, a reminder about Chicken Joe. He still has no enemies, but that doesn't stop people from trying to capture him. He gets away, and you know why? He's just chill like that. Also, he calls the native penguins the Penguins because of the island Pengu, and honestly, I think the writers named the island that just so they could make that joke. We're back to Cody again, who made a surfboard and then got in a fight with Big Z because of how bad his surfboard was. As Cody is storming off, he bumps into Lonnie, who decides to, for some reason, take him to, like, the secret evil volcano tunnels of Pengu Island. Like, yeah, the sequence is cool. It was cool enough to inspire a game on the DVD bonus features. But my big problem with it is anybody that goes here has, like, an 80% chance of dying. Like, you miss a single turn or that one jump, even by a little bit, you are dead. Whatever, though. After this, Cody and Lonnie bond. She tells Cody that Big Z is her uncle and also the only family she has. So now Cody feels bad, so he goes back to Big Z, and he makes a surfboard the right way and then tries to get Big Z to train him, and he actually does agree this time. Cody says, let's go, get in the water, surfing, and Big Z goes, no, what are you talking about? We don't start like that. Main Pengu Island is still setting up for the big surf-off. Remember, that's the big event of this movie. Reggie doesn't care about anyone else, Mikey's doing all the work, and Chicken Joe still has no enemies. Through a bunch of pranks and just kind of general dicking around, Big Z finally gets through to Cody on what the most important part about surfing is, and that's, of course, having fun. Now, remember when I said Big Z wasn't quite the Sigma he appears to be? I still stand by that statement, but I will make an amendment to it. Big Z may not be the GOAT, but do you know who is GOATed? Geek. Geek teaches Cody how to surf and have fun about it, and that makes the world good again. Surfing becomes fun for Big Z again, too. Cody still cares a little bit too much about the tournament, which disappoints Big Z because that's, like, the antithesis of what he's trying to teach him. They get into a little bit of a fight, and Cody starts to head back to the main Pengu Island for the tournament on his own. Here's the thing, Cody does not know how to have no enemies just yet. He gets captured by the Penguins, and who's here to help him out? Chicken Joe. He uses his powers of stoicism to get him out of the snare he's stuck in, and they get back to Pengu Island for the main tournament. During the tournament, Cody gets flashbacks of all the mean things that people said to him throughout the movie, and he channels the Midwest emo inside of him to make it to the finals. Tank also makes it to the finals, not because he's, like, good at surfing or something, but because we need an antagonist here, and there hasn't been one most of the movie. Chicken Joe also makes it to the finals, and when he hears that, you know what he says? He goes, yo, we get to surf some more, that's awesome! How do you not love this guy.
The Cloud looks just like a kitten.
In the finals of the tournament, Tank Evans tries to style on Cody and then just completely wipes out Skill Issue. Cody realizes right then and there what surfing is actually all about. Surfing isn't about trying to get the most points or winning a surfing competition. Surfing is just about being a really cool dude who's chill and just wants to hit those cool waves. Surprise, bitch! Tank Evans is back! Finally channeling the stoicism that was inside him all along, Cody is able to save Chicken Joe at the cost of him getting pushed into the Boneyards. I should have mentioned the Boneyards a lot sooner in this video. Quick thing, the Boneyards are the very like sick and twisted dangerous part of the Pangu Island surfing area. Most people die there. That's how Big Z died, actually. I should have mentioned it then. Cody gets pushed into the Boneyards. Tank Evans crashes in the Boneyards. Cody tried to save him though. He has learned how to have no enemies, but it's not enough because another wave comes crashing down on top of Cody. The crowd watches this wave crash down and they're understandably crushed by the idea that yet another promising surfer's life has been claimed by the Boneyards. Understanding this and understanding the vulnerability of the audience right now, James Woods walks up and immediately starts trying to profit off of them. What a dick move. That's like building an entire video to talk about a movie, and then right before the conclusion of the movie happens, you're asking the audience to like or subscribe, which you should do, though. I won't even ask for both, just a like or subscribe. I'm not gonna be greedy. Inside the Eye of the Storm, Cody isn't dead yet. Somebody has come to save him. It's Cody's hero. Not Big Z, but Geek. Geek still knows everything about how the waves work. He's still one of the best surfers out there. And he reminds Cody of the lessons and trust that he's instilled in him from earlier, and because of that, the two of them survive the Boneyards. They then paddle back to shore, tell James Woods to BTFO, and then everybody suddenly starts to realize what surfing is all about. It's about just having fun. Sports in general are really just about having fun. Sure, there's the rush of competition, but if you enjoy a sport and you don't enjoy losing at that sport, I would argue that you don't actually enjoy it and you just enjoy winning. The same thing applies when we're talking about a Sigma male. You can enjoy what you do, but if you don't enjoy that thing without some arbitrary value of success placed on it, I would argue that you don't actually love that thing, you just love being successful. That's the lesson that Surf's Up really tries to teach. It talks about how being a winner isn't the most important thing. To enjoy something, you have to just enjoy the sport for what it is. Cody had to lose the tournament to learn that. Big Z had to lose the same way to learn the same thing. But do you know who didn't have to lose the tournament? Do you know who already had that idea and that thing instilled into them? It was Chicken Joe. That's why Chicken Joe wins the tournament. He didn't care about winning, he didn't need to win, he was just there to enjoy surfing. To the point when they announce that he's the winner, his first response is,
I won?
That's such a genuinely profound statement from this 2007 Penguin movie. The idea that you don't need to win, and by not needing to win, that's how you truly win. That's why, from a literary standpoint, that's why Chicken Joe wins. It's because he doesn't need to. He doesn't need to learn the lesson. He's built all of it. He's already this rare example of a good character that is also a good person. Is he the most complex character of all time? No. But he genuinely, truly embodies the themes of loyalty, sportsmanship, and competition. He has these perfect ideas of self-sufficiency and success in a way that doesn't need outside validation. If that's not the perfect example of a Sigma male, I don't know what is. And they made a direct-to-DVD sequel 9 years later with The Undertaker. Nothing is sacred.